there was just a sense of global outrage over what the U.S. was doing in Guantanamo. Very early on, there were reports of detainees being mistreated, interrogated in brutal ways, and just the very notion of holding people indefinitely without charge just caused a lot of outrage in the world. There was this really famous photo that the Pentagon released right as soon as they landed with these detainees in these orange jumpsuits. You know, some of them were blindfolded when they came off the plane. They were kneeling on the ground in these like steel cages outside. And the steel cages were really interesting because it showed just how unprepared the U.S. was to hold hundreds of detainees on this sleepy Navy base in Cuba. I mean, they essentially weren't ready. You know, they didn't have anything. There was no infrastructure there. They had these wooden huts where they did the interrogations. The Obama administration made a big effort to close it and just wasn't able to do it. They made a lot of progress. They got close. They reduced the detainee population, but they weren't able to close it. And that is essentially where Biden has it now. Like, can he get, you know, the ball all the way down the field? Like, he's got 39 more detainees. He's got to figure out what to do with them. So we're only talking about a few people here. The really difficult issue is, what do you do with the people who've been charged by military commission? And within that, the real question is, what do you do with the five guys who are charged with their role in the September 11th attacks? The main guy is this guy, Khalid Sheikh Mohammed. He has described himself as the mastermind of the September 11th attacks. At some point, he said he came up with the plan from A to Z. If it ever goes to trial, it will be a jury of military officers who decide his fate. It's a death penalty case, so in theory, these guys could get the death penalty if convicted. Will we ever get to that? We don't know. This thing has been dragged on since May 2012 in the pretrial stage. There have been 42 rounds of pretrial hearings. If that prohibition remains outside the Pentagon authorization bill, and if they strip the funding for the detention center, then the Biden administration will have a pretty straightforward path to closing Guantanamo. Now, that doesn't mean releasing everyone, because they're still going to have those people that they want to hold on to, that small group of subset of prisoners, including the suspects in the 9/11 case, that they will have to move to the United States and put on trial.